different when I began. We had outdated technology. The software was almost unusable. It was, the information in there was corrupt, and we knew we were writing handwritten tickets. And we had just received our audit from Newland and Company, deeming parking unauditable. So that wasn't, that was something I was charged with to fix. The entire chapter of ordinances, as we discovered, were mostly from the 80s. There were some 1990s updates, but for the most part, it was an extremely outdated chapter. The ticket rates were 25 to 50% of what I found in the surrounding Montana cities, so they were too low. Like, with too low ticket rates, you're really looking at, you're not causing any sort of deterrence. They were gladly accepting the $2 and $5 tickets all day long because they didn't hurt their pocketbook, really. The collection of unpaid tickets was only at approximately 37%, based on the figures that I can find in that database. It's difficult, but from what I see, I originally thought it was around 45 after being here a little longer. It looks like it was about 37, and I will say that much of that was because of the limited technology. We simply, there was not much we could do with it. So the new technology was a must. Northwestern Energy building was slated to begin a couple of months after I began, which was, we're going to be losing 38 paid parking spaces and some street parking spaces, so we knew we were losing 50 prime parking spaces right in the center of where we needed them. So there was that facing us, where we were looking at really no plan in place yet, so we, that was a, almost a scramble. We didn't have any inventory or list of a permit of our permit holders, so when it began time to look at where to put these 38, basically the way that the old system worked was simply selling them. You were selling the piece of paper that said this is, we could sort of keep track month to month how many we sold, but it didn't keep that person's space for them. It was the first come, first served purchase until the lots were filling up. And that worked when we weren't pushed, but at the point that we lost those prime spaces, we discovered that there were some we didn't have spaces for, so we were able to really come up with a plan using that software to do that. Over 100 signs were missing in Uptown regarding the two-hour district mostly. I think the figure was probably more like 120 signs were missing. You can't write a ticket or enforce it where there's no signage. Lack of information in the office, so when the public would ask questions, we didn't really have maps, we didn't have information on the ordinances. Nothing to provide people to clarify or to educate or to redirect them where to park. The webpage had not been updated with the switchover from Butte-Silver Boat. Our webpage had nothing. It basically stated where we were located and the board members were on it. The payment situation in the office was that they could walk all the way in to a single person sitting in the office. And it's not the making the payment part that was dangerous. It was the ones that didn't want to make the payment and they wanted to argue. So when you have a situation where you have cash in an office, and you're writing tickets, that was an unsafe environment. And